what we like and what we're going to see in the world title match. You're going to get more of it when DDP and the Giant go at it. And hey, hey, Ric Flair's in the house. If I can steal that from the Wolfpack, and Ric Flair, you can better believe, is still here somewhere. And I can tell you, and I don't know this for a fact, because we're here and they're there, but I would imagine that he is still looking for Bischoff somewhere in this fast TWA dome.
Still hot on the trail of Eric Bischoff. The Four Horsemen have made their presence felt in St. Louis, Missouri this evening on Nitro. How'd you like that little calling card that they left in the locker room with Scott Norton?
Yeah, they found Norman. What a Christmas spirit relief that is to know the Nature Boy is okay. His ticker was pumping, brother. Bischoff is not off the hook.
Can you imagine what Ric Flair has endured? Just think about this. What he has had to endure at the hands of this maniac. Loss of income, loss of a job for a time, legal proceedings, the stress of that, and then to really put the icing on the cake, to use that old cliche, the underhanded thing that he violated the man's family is what he did.
You know, I think that almost loss of income pales in comparison to the personal vendetta that Eric Bischoff has against Ric Flair. We've all seen it go down over the course of the past couple of weeks, and it just came to a head tonight. Flair's blood is just boiling. I can't wait until Starrcade.
So Flair is seemingly okay, and I don't know. I know we have all these great matches scheduled. Yes, we still have Goldberg and Scott Hall, and that, fans, is a big-time main event we have for you later on. But we got to try to talk to Flair to see how he is, how he's feeling, what exactly happened. Hopefully, we can try to do that during the course of this program. I implore our producers, please, let's try to at least. I know he's just filled with emotion right now and adrenaline, but we've got to try to settle the man down and see exactly what was wrong. Here is Rat in Lismark. As awesome as Rat is, there's no doubt. I apologize, Rat, that I apologize, Lismark. I should be talking about your match, but nope. Too much excitement going on here in the Starrcade. Just too much to talk, too much to cover, too much to think about. All the great Starrcades, and I'm involved with just about all of them. I don't ever remember anything like this. Anything like this. Lismark.
Now you threw me off. I'm thinking of Starrcade. Well, watching the match.
The world's thinking of Starrcade, Larry. Join the crowd here. Pick up. Knocking down Ben Rath. Think about how important Flair has been to Starrcade, how he's been in the world title match, the feature match. I've said this before, but it bears repeating again. He's never had a more important match than he has coming up on the 27th, and all the great title matches against Harley Race, against Dusty Rhodes, two of them against Dusty Rhodes, against Sting. For Starrcade in 1990 was right here in this city. Would he face Sting? He's had some big matches, but nothing like this.
Tony, make a great point. You think of all those historic world title matches that Ric Flair has been a part of at Starrcade. Well, because of the personal issues that are at stake in this matchup against Eric Bischoff this Sunday, I think that Flair, deep down in his heart, is looking forward to this matchup against Eric Bischoff even more than all those other world title bouts, if you can believe that.
It's like what we're going to see with Goldberg and Nash for the world title. In many ways not. But it's also like what we're going to see with DDP and the Giant. DDP, as much as Flair wants to get at Eric Bischoff, we know DDP has the same designs for the Giant. It's just a little bit different road to take. We'll go up against 7 feet 4. Oh, we almost got a pin there. How about that?
Talked about physically dominating athletes so far here on Nitro. Well, that pattern continues with Wrath, the master of the meltdown. Talk about wrestlers with momentum and on a roll. How about Wrath?
Yeah, rolled in a little too slow right there for big man. Wrath usually very fast, and he sees him coming.
Wrath caught him. Oh, what a move.
That's that death penalty move. That's a finishing hold that we've seen out of Wrath before, but it looks like tonight he's using it, well, maybe a prelude or a setup. to the meltdown.
Death penalty move.
Just showing us how many weapons he does have. And runs over the man with a left shoulder block that time. Rap.
Sounds like the thing Flair just put on Bischoff.
What about the thing he is going to put on Bischoff? Hard one on the meltdown is that pump handle. And one of those moves that you can hear and see. The fans know it's coming. The opponent knows it's coming. There's just nothing they can do about it. It's over.
And the Richter scale.
The body count continues.
Ric Flair is in the building somewhere. We hope to hear from him again. Larry, you gonna get your Nitro Girl challenge?
I've already got one, thanks.
One for each room in the house, I'm sure. All right, as the Santa's Little Helpers, and we said the brand new Nitro Girl Storm is joining the group as well. We saw her earlier. We'll let you know that Thunder comes to Richmond, Virginia, the Coliseum on January 7th, the Thursday night. Tickets to the box office and Ticketmaster. And on January 21st, Indianapolis, in the Market Square Arena, we're going to have Thunder tickets at the box office and Ticketmaster there.
In the first month there, January, is AC, the blue-eyed little goddess herself.
Hey, we're in the Christmas mood. We got the Christmas spirit, and I tell you, if nothing else, Flair put us in the mode. And fans will let you know this.